this is not Hallelujah. No, it was the blood. Glory God. Thank you, Jesus, for your blood. My God, you can't understand that song unless you didn't been through some things. Unless you've experienced life, unless you've experienced that little G God on your trail, and you understand that if it had not been for the blood of Jesus to save me from myself and to save me from this sinful world, oh, where would I be? Thank you, Lord, for getting up. Thank you for all you've done. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. My baby took us back old school, boy. Them Baptists. That's one of them old Baptist songs, boy. Yes. They be coming down the aisles singing.
Yes.
Got the man up there with the Jerry Carroll singing and head back. I know it was the blood. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Well, we thank God for today. We thank God for what this day is a representation of, for this Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know one thing is not. It's not about the bunny rabbit. It is about Jesus and him rising. On today, and we thank God for another day to come and to fellowship with one another as one body in Christ Jesus. See, it's one thing to be able to fellowship and to be by yourself at home. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's not, you can be at home and seek God and praise God and do all those things. But it's another thing,
my God, you gotta say
when
that.
You can fellowship with the brethren,
yes.
and hug each other and love on each other. And, you know, I'm going to tell you, it's been so many times where I've been going through and had a brother or a sister at church give me a word. Or get a hug from one of them old mothers. And they hug you and tell you it's going to be all right. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes you need that. And then sometimes you got a word that you need to give to somebody. Or a smile they need to see. Or somebody just need to see that you are in service one more time. See, this thing is a team effort. That's why the Bible says, don't forsake yourself, the assembling together. You know, it's something about when we come together and fellowship as one body in Christ. Hallelujah. And we just want to thank those that are here worshiping with us this morning at the Master's Touch Worship Center. Yes. For those of you who don't know, I am the pastor, John Slaughter. And this beautiful specimen of a woman here is Lady Monica, my beautiful wife. And we just thank God, man, that, you know, you've come to fellowship with us. We thank God that you chose this Sunday to come and to be a part of this service. We thank God for you. And then those that may be joining us on Facebook Live, we thank God for you. And what else is that, baby?
Instagram.
Hallelujah. We are on Instagram as well.
Wow.
So we thank those that may be joining on Instagram. We appreciate you choosing the Master's Touch Worship Center to fellowship this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we will move on through the service. We're going to have our scripture, prayer, and announcements by none other than my Lady Monica. And then we're also going to have this morning's Lady Monica-ism this morning. So with that being said, Lady Monica, are you ready to do your mini duties?
I am. I will be obedient to God's word.
All right now. Hallelujah. So we will have Lady Monica to come. She wears many hats. What beautiful this morning,
though. Thank you. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I said good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It was good when they said, let's come into the house of the Lord. And we're going to give scripture today. If you guys would turn in your Bibles with me. And that will come from 1 John. Chapter 4, and it reads as follows. Dear friends, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirit to see if they are from God.
My God.
Because many false prophets have gone out into the world.
Mm.
This is how you know the spirit of God. Every spirit that has confessed that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh and is from God, is from God. But every spirit that does not confess Jesus Christ is not from God. This is the spirit of the Antichrist, which you have heard is coming. Even now, now is already in the world. I read to you 1 John 4 chapter verses 1 through 3.
Amen.
And may God bless the hearers and the readers of his read word. Now, if everyone could stand up for me, please, so we can come together and bow down to the at the altar to God. Father God, we come, God. Just first, God, just thanking you, God, for another Resurrection Sunday, God. We just thank you, God, for your blood, God, that you shed, God. But thank you, God, for rising up.
Hallelujah.
Rising up, God, and taking our sins, God, with you, God. And I just want to thank you, Father, for who you are, God. Father, I pray that, God, we'll be obedient to your word today, God. God, if there's anyone that's out there that don't know you as a pardon of their sin, that there's somewhere where they can receive your word, God, your holy word. I pray, God, that you touch these your people, God, that are lost, God, that need you, God, that don't know what the blood can do, God, in their life, God. The blood has healing, God. The blood has cleansing, God. The blood covers the multitude of all sins, God. And I just want to thank you, Father, for sending your son, God. Thank you for allowing him to lay on the cross, God, and for the atonement for our sins, God. I just want to thank you, God, for raising him up, God, so that we will have a living God, that we don't serve a statue. We don't serve Buddha. We don't serve man, but we serve our almighty God. And I just thank you, God, for who you are, God. And I pray, God, that this service be what you would have it to be, God. Let this man come and bring forth your word, God. Speak through him, God. Decrease him and increase you, God, in his walk, God, so he can lead this ministry, God, to what you would have it to be, God. God, I just thank you, God. I give you all the praise, God. I give you all the glory, God. I just thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. And I just want to thank you, Father, for this day again, God. Thank you for allowing us to be here in your presence, God. We lay our praise at the altar, our cares at the altar, God. And I just love you, God, and we praise you forevermore. In the matchless name of Jesus, God, let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay, we're going to go into the announcements. So this morning, announcements. Don't forget, you know, you guys, we had an awesome couples retreat. Did we not? We talked about what is your return on your investment. What's your return on your investment? And we were able to share with others about our return on our investment. So, you know, it's just like if you put no money in the bank, you get no money out of it, right? You can't go and withdraw. Am I right?
Amen.
If your credit card has zero balance, you can't charge nothing, right?
That's it.
So you get nothing.
That's
so if you put nothing into your relationship, nothing to your marriage, if you don't have God as your bank,
look at you,
you know, if you don't have God as your bank so he can deposit in you and fill you up so you can have a God-fearing relationship so you can enjoy your marriage, dump out that old water and let small drips of clean water come into your relationship. That's what we talked about. So if you missed it, go back to Facebook, go to YouTube, and look at that. It was awesome. So on this Thursday, we will have Bible study, and Pastor Slaughter is speaking from the seven churches. So be here. Bring your Bibles, bring your pads, bring your paper, you know, bring all the things you need to take notes. So you can have this information so you can share with others about what the seven churches is about.
Amen.
And the services start at 7 o'clock. We're here at 3331 Blue Ridge Road at the lower level of St. Paul's. So don't forget to come. And we have our Sunday morning worship here every Sunday. We're here this Sunday on Resurrection Sunday. And we thank God for this day. We thank God for that he rose from the grave, God, and we just thank you for who he is. So don't forget to visit us on every Sunday at 8:30, and you can follow us on Twitter at TMTWC1, and follow us on Facebook at TMTWC, and then like us on our Facebook, not Pastor Slaughter's or mine, but TMTWC.
Amen.
And subscribe to our YouTube channel at TMTWC. And then our Instagram, which we're going live today.
Yay!
like us, follow us, you know, send us comments, encouragements. Amen. We'll take criticism, because you know what? We're going to take it to God.
Amen.
That's what we're going to do. And and you can always go to our website at tmtwc.org, where you can get all of our information about where we are, what we're doing, and all our community service. And now we're going to go with the Monica-ism.
All right, now.
Okay. So, God's free gift of salvation is offered to everyone. Mm. It doesn't matter your religion or your culture background. Mm. Jesus Christ died for you. Mm. Accept the gift of salvation and be sure where you are going to spend your eternity. Love consists in this. Mm. Not what we love, but God, that He loved us. He sent His Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Mm. So remember, this salvation is free.
My God.
Okay? Mm. You can't buy it.
Right.
You can't put it on credit.
Right.
Ain't about your credit score. Mm. Ain't about what your mama believed or what your daddy believed or nothing. It can't be advertised for you to get it.
Mm.
You have to, it's free will.
Hallelujah.
So God has given His love for free.
Amen.
And it's a love that surpassed all other love.
Say that, girl.
So remember,
say that.
That if you're lost,
yes, sir.
If you're on drugs,
yeah.
If you're prostituting, if you're lying, if you're cheating,
yeah.
It's covered under the blood. And the salvation is free.
Good God.
So we thank you, God, for your salvation, for giving us free salvation.
Glory.
And now, God, we're going to move into our morning worship.
Hallelujah.
And you guys get ready, get your monies, get your iPads in hand so you can pay by internet.
Right.
We receive it by Tithely and Givify.
Yes.
You can go onto our website. We have Cash App, TMTWC. Cash it to us. We'll take it. Yes. We'll take the coins. We'll take the folds. We'll take the checks. It don't matter.
Go
we will also take your prayers.
Amen.
Because you know what? We send them up to God, and God rained down on us. So if you all would stand and get ready for our offering, and Pastor Slaughter is going around. You ain't got to get up. Pastor Slaughter going around with the bucket. So tap the bucket if you don't have anything, that you're asking God to bless you, that you're asking God to be a blessing. So, Father God, we just thank you, Father, for those that are being obedient. And now we come to you. Can you stand, please? So we can all stand so we can pray over the offering. Father God, we come to you, God, just thanking you for your many, 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 many blessings, God. Thank you for allowing the blessings to rain down, God, to come from every area, God. We just thank you for covering us, God. And we lift this offering up to you, God, that it will be that we use it for the edification for your kingdom, God. And we just thank you forevermore. And thank you those for that who gave and those that had the desire but did not have the means but touched the bucket in faith.
Hallelujah.
And we just thank you, God, for who you are, and we love you. In your name, Jesus, amen. Now we're going to have our Pastor Slaughter come on up here, and we're going to have our song of worship. And then the next voice you will hear is our own Pastor John T. Slaughter. Yes, my baby.
Serving up here.
Good. Great. Hallelujah. Good God Almighty. Boy, that Monica-ism turned into a mini sermonette. The Lord just ran with that, boy. Good word, baby. Good God Almighty. Wow, that was a good word. Thank God for His blood. Good God Almighty. Woo. All right, I'm getting carried away now. This is not our music. This is not our music. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Turn that up. Hallelujah. Good God Almighty. God, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We honor you, God, for the sweet, sweet spirit that is in this place. Lord, we ask that you would stand up right now in the name of Jesus. Run rampant in this place. Touch each and every person that is represented here today. And God, move in a mighty way. In the name of Jesus, Lord, you speak and preach today. Hallelujah. Thank you for the songs that you've sang, God. Thank you for the glory that has fallen in this place. We feel your presence, God, and we thank you, God, for all you are and all that you're doing. God, have your way. Touch our heart right now, Father, that is in need. Prepare minds and hearts for your word to go forth and change lives today. God, we love you, we thank you, and we honor you. It's in the name of Jesus that we pray. And everybody said, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Thank God for the day. Boy, it's been a beautiful day already. My God. Just to feel the presence of the Lord. Woo, Jesus, bless your holy name.
Yes.
Bless your holy name. Well, this morning, beloved, my plan is not to be before you long, but God definitely has a word on today. And I just thank God for his presence. You know, I had been praying to God about this word. He has had it in my spirit for a long time. You know, I've often testified about what my wife, my family has gone through over the last at least 2 or 3 years, more intently last year. And the Lord gave me a word. He gave me a word when we were really, really, really going through. And, you know, and I'm, you know, a preacher. I've been a preacher. God called me since 1998. And I've been running for him and preaching and doing ministry. And but I'd got to a point where I was like, Lord, I mean, I'm not the man I used to be. You know, I'm trying to do right. I'm living for you. I'm preaching for you. I'm doing the right things right. I ain't perfect, but I'm doing right things right. And all of these things, good God Almighty, are going on. Just finances not right, and just the rent, you can't pay rent, and I mean, I could go on and on. Jobs, don't know what's going on. Business that was flourishing at one time, just all of a sudden, just a halt. Just nothing. And I'm like, God, what is going on? I'm fighting every day to do what you want me to do, how you want me to do it, and my life, good God Almighty, just seems to be falling all around me. And I remember I was at home. This is when I was doing life insurance full time, and I worked from home. And, oh, Jesus, I was at home and making phone calls and trying to get some business going, as I have usually done. And God has blessed me. But for some reason, this everything was just falling apart. And I heard this song. And I heard this song before and played it and, you know, and it encouraged me before, but this time, God gave me this song, and when I heard it, it was like the glory, God's glory just fell on me. And all I could do is cry and just thank him. And cried some more, and I thanked him, and I thanked him, and all I could do was say, Lord, I thank you. I thank you. It was like he reminded me that no matter what you are going through, I'm with you. Woo, God. And my prayer today is that as I give this word that God has given to me, that it blesses you as much as it has blessed, is blessing, and shall bless me. Hallelujah. So with that being said, I want to use as a title today, God is doing. God is doing a great work. Man, I'm going to need a hanky or something because I ain't going to be able to get through this thing without shedding some tears. God is doing a great work. Do y'all know what those words mean? And just let me give you scripture for those of you that may need scripture. Philippians 1 and 6. Thank you, baby. Philippians 1 and 6 says, being confident of this very thing, hallelujah, that he who has begun a good work, hallelujah, in you will complete it, glory God, until the day of Jesus Christ. God is doing a great work in you. And beloved, let me just say, and this is the word.
My drink ready.
This is the word that God gave me. He said, a great work is not what it looks like. But a great work is what God says it is. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. A great work is not what it looks like. For a great work is what God says it is. Mm-hmm. So, beloved, my prayer today is that I, through the power of the Holy Spirit that dwells in me, can make you aware that no matter where you are in your life, no matter what you're doing, no matter what you're going through, no matter what it feels like, no matter what it looks like, that God, hallelujah, is doing a great work. Glory God. I was told myself I was going to calm down today. That God is doing a great work in you. He's doing a great work in you. And you don't have to drive a Mercedes for him to be doing a great work. You ain't got to have hundreds of thousands of dollars in your bank account for him to be doing a great work. You ain't got to live in a mansion, hallelujah, on the top of a hill. You ain't got to be wearing Sean John and all the best clothes for God to be doing a great work in you. For the Bible says that being confident, Paul says, of this very thing, hallelujah, that he who has begun a good work. So what Paul is basically saying that once you accept Christ as your personal Savior, once you confess with your mouth, Romans says, and believe in your heart, hallelujah, that is the beginning, glory God, of a great work that God is doing in your life. See, one thing that I've understood in life is that there's valleys in life. And then when you're in the valley, beloved, that's your training ground. That's where God is developing you. That's where God he's taking you through things so that you will know that he's with you. That he will never leave you nor forsake you. He's training you so that way as you're climbing, hallelujah, out of the valley, and you're striving for the mountaintop, you can still be humbled because you know where you came from. Hallelujah. And I know when I married this beautiful woman that I know God gave me. See, God knew that when he brought us together, he was bringing something together that he ordained before the foundations of the world. He was bringing something together that he knew that the Master Touch Worship Center would be birthed, hallelujah, through this union. So he had to take us through certain things in our lives to create this great work that he needed to bring forth. See, he had to birth something in us, in our marriage. And I've never been pregnant before, but they tell me when you go through being pregnant, it's uncomfortable. When you go through being pregnant, you go through things. Your body, good God Almighty, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your body goes through changes. And I have a friend of mine who just realized she was pregnant and she was coming to work and throwing up every day because her body was going through changes, getting prepared for something to be birthed. Good God Almighty. Hey, God. See, even at that moment, when your body is going through changes and the woman's body, she starts gaining weight and her face gains weight and she starts going through stuff. Why? Because there's something, hallelujah, being birthed, glory God, in her. There's a great work, hallelujah, that's happening in her body. So what God does, and the strange thing about a woman giving birth is that man today still cannot totally explain and understand how liquid from a man goes into liquid of a woman, and somehow that woman's body forms a solid that's developed over a certain time. Why is that? Because God is doing a great work. Hallelujah. He's doing a great work in the birth of that child. So, beloved, know this. Oh, God, Lord, slow me down, Jesus. Beloved, know this, that as you're going through life and once you accept, hallelujah, once you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior. At that point, God is doing a great work in you. You may not see the manifestation of it right now. Hallelujah. You may not understand why certain things in your life may not be the way you want it right now. Hallelujah. But know this, hallelujah, that he that has begun, hallelujah, a good work in you will complete it, glory God, until the day of Jesus Christ. Know this, beloved, that he that began that good work is going to complete it. It's going to come to fruition, but you got to go through some birth pains. Hallelujah. You got to go through a point in your life where God is showing you, he's getting you ready for the blessings that's coming to you. You know, a few weeks ago, I was at work and I was looking at a lot of these guys, and these girls are making so much money at my job. And I was just looking, I was like, God, I mean, you can, if a lot of these people ain't saved and they making all this money, driving all these fancy cars, and you hear them talking about doing these wonderful weekends and wonderful vacations and all this money they have. And then I look at some Christians that struggle and go through, and I was thinking, you know, well, what's going on? Well, why is there such a difference and what's happening? And the word that God gave me, he let me know that when you in him, he doesn't want you to have the money and the things to have you. He don't want the money to be your God. He don't want the car and the vacations and all the things of the world to be your God. So what he has to do with us is he has to make sure that he is our God.
Yes, yes.
Like my bishop used to say, you don't want the things to have you. Uh-huh. You want God to have you. And once God know he has you, then, hallelujah, he can give you the things. Because once you get the things, they don't become your God. Because you remember the great work, hallelujah, the process that he took you through. You remember where I came from, hallelujah. You remember what you brought me through. You remember that I didn't get here through my own self, hallelujah. But I got here because of the great work, hallelujah, that God is doing in my life. So now when I have the nice cars and the house and all the money, those things don't have me. Because God has my heart. And I know that when that day comes and I gotta give an answer, hallelujah. For the Bible says that we all, hallelujah, must give an answer on that day, that every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess. I don't want my answer to be that I was rich and I was wealthy, but I didn't have God. That I had all the things that this world says I should have, but I did not have Jesus on my side. Glory God, glory God, hallelujah. So beloved, as we march through today, if you hear nothing else that was said today, I ask you that you hear that a great work is not what it looks like or what it feels like, but a great work, hallelujah, hallelujah, is what God, hallelujah, says it is. And my Bible tells me, he says that I will never leave you, hallelujah, nor forsake you. He says that I want great things for you. Yes. That I know the expected end that I have for you. That I want you to be great is what God says. He loves us. Yes. And don't worry about what the doctor says. Hallelujah. Don't worry about what the checkbook says. You better go to God and know what the word of God says. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So as we go through there, there's two men in the Bible, hallelujah, who God started something with them, and he did a great work in these men. But beloved, it didn't start out that way. Mm-hmm. See, when God is doing a great work, any great work, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, that is done has to start with a foundation. It always starts small. If you look at the crops in the land, the corn in the fields, the fruit tree, the beans, all the produce, everything you see in the supermarket, it didn't just start that way. Hallelujah. It had to start from a seed. And that seed had to be planted in a ground. And it had to be watered. And then it busted through the seed. And then it had to go through different weather and rain and sun and all these things, and it had to go through something for it to be produced and what it is. When you build a house, a house is not just built from what you see. It's not just there. You know, the longest part to build a house is to build the foundation. So, beloved, my point today is that know that God is doing a great work in you. But as he's doing the great work, he has to build a great foundation. Hallelujah. He has to build a foundation that great work can stand on. Because there's so many people that have been given so much, and they're raised up and have all of these things, and then fall for temptation, fall in the things of this world, commit suicide, and strung out on drugs. Why? Because the foundation was not right. So, beloved, today we want to talk about two men in the Bible. And the first man is David. David. A lot of you may not know this, but there are 66 chapters in the Bible just about David. The Bible and the New Testament references David 59 times. In the New Testament alone. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. And beloved, it was David in Psalms 34 and 1 who said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. That was David that said that. Now you would think that somebody saying that is high and mighty. You would think that somebody that's saying that is everything in their life is right. That everything in their life is going on. That all the bills are paid. That they're living in a nice house, got a secure job, got a beautiful mate, beautiful children, driving a nice car, that everything is right. So now I can say, I will bless the Lord, hallelujah, at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth, hallelujah. But beloved, let me bring your attention to something. That when David wrote this psalm, he was actually in the midst of running from Saul. He was in the midst of he was in the front of King Achish and had to act like he was a crazy man because he thought he was going to die. He had all of these things going on in his life, and he chose to say, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Why? Because he knew God was looking for his response. My God. He knew God was looking for the response that David would give. And beloved, the same God is looking for your response. Yes. For what you're dealing with and like anything you're going through. God wants to see what your response will be. Will your response be, oh, pitiful me. Oh, God. Oh, Lord, help me, help me, help me, help me, help me. Or will your response be, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. See, if we take a look over David's life, see, a lot of people look at King David, one of the greatest kings in Israel, conquered all of these other kingdoms, did so many great things, had so many riches and all these great things. But beloved, it didn't start out that way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, David started as just a little shepherd boy in the field by himself, shepherding the flocks for his father. Nobody even knew about him. He was out there shepherding the flocks. But when he was out there, he did the best job that he could do. See, in the field, he was fighting lions and fighting bears to protect his father's flock. It was in the field that he learned how to play the harp. And he didn't know that even at that time, when he was learning to play the harp, that God would use that gift to be a blessing to King Saul. See, it was at that time that King Saul, hallelujah, was being tormented by an evil spirit that God sent to King Saul because of what King Saul did not do for God. And he was being tormented. And the king's men knew that David was anointed, hallelujah, and playing the harp. Who was David? He was a nobody in the field tending sheep. And they called on him to come in and play the harp for King Saul. And David was so anointed when he played the harp that while David played the harp, the evil spirit would leave. And the king could have some solitude. And he could be at ease and at peace with himself when David played the harp. See, David was the least of Jesse's kids. And when Samuel came looking for a king, God told Samuel to go to Jesse's house. Hallelujah. And when Samuel walked in the house, he saw Jesse's oldest son, big, tall, broad shoulders, and he looked like a king. And Samuel said, this must be the king that he wants me to anoint. And God told him, he said, uh-uh. You looking on the outside, You looking at his situation. You looking at the circumstances around him. You looking what man sees. But the Bible said, God said, I don't look at what outside of a man. He said, I look at the heart, hallelujah, of a man. And beloved, that is my message to you today. Is God is not concerned with what's going on around you. God is doing a great work in you. And it's not a great work of things. It's not a great work of what's happening around you. He wants to do a great work in your heart. He wants to fill you up with his Holy Spirit. He wants to get you ready for what he has planned for you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Hallelujah. He's doing a great work in you. So don't get caught up. Hallelujah. And everything that's going on around you. You get caught up in knowing that he is with you. And he will never forsake you. For see, it was King David, hallelujah, that got caught up in deception. It was King David that got caught up in conspiracy, murder, and lying. It was King David that saw Bathsheba bathing on the roof of the house. And sent her husband to the front line that he may be killed so he can sleep with his wife. It was that David that was going through all of that. And God was still doing a great work in his life. Why? Because his heart was in the right place. Because he was seeking God. Because he chose to no matter what kind of sin that he was caught in, he chose to truly repent and turn from his wicked ways. He was a man whose heart and life was centered in Christ. Not a perfect man. But he was still a fleshly man. But his heart, hallelujah, was in the right place. And beloved, let me tell you, there's a lot of us that are going through that will continue to go through because your heart ain't right. You got things that are going on in your heart that you are choosing to hold on to, and you're not choosing to lay it down to God and give it to him. There's some things that happened in your childhood. There's some relationships that you still hold on to. There's some business decisions that you made and you're still beating yourself up for. There's some things that you've done in your life that you've not forgiven yourself for. God, hallelujah, has forgiven you. But you've not forgiven yourself, and it's eaten up, hallelujah, your heart. Well, beloved, allow God to continue the great work that he's doing in you and give it to him. Today, hallelujah, lay it down at the altar, glory God. And give it to him. For it's never too late to give it to God that he may continue to do, hallelujah, that great work. For he continued to do the great work in David. No matter what he went through, no matter what he did, God continued to do the great work, hallelujah. And then, beloved, this last person that we want to talk about, this last man that God continued to do a great work, is in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. See, when we say Jesus and we think about Jesus, we think about the power and the majesty, and he came from heaven, and he ruled this earth, and he walked on water. He did all these great things. But beloved, there was a Garden of Gethsemane. There was a Garden of Gethsemane where Jesus spent, and he went through pain and agony. The Bible says that when he was sweating, that the drips of sweat was like blood for all the agony and the pain that he was going through. Why? Because he knew what his great work entailed. See, a great work ain't always walking through the lilies in the valleys and skipping through life and everything is good for you. I was telling my son, my oldest son, who has great aspirations and he wants to do great things and he has a great plan and he wants to do all of these great things. But I told him, son, that it don't get caught up in all these people that tell you these great things that you can do. Don't think that you're just going to drive a Mercedes next week because that's what you want to do. That there's a process that you got to go through. That you don't see the heartache and the pain. You don't see the bologna sandwiches and the ketchup sandwiches that they had to eat and the sacrifices that was made to get where these people got in life. Hallelujah. And beloved, when we think about Jesus, we forget about the Garden of Gethsemane. We forget about the agony that he went through and the heartache and the pain. Why? Because he knew what he was going to have to go through. For he said in Luke 22, 42 and 43, he said, Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me. See, he knew in his flesh what he was going to have to go through. See, it wasn't that when he hung on the cross that because he was Jesus, he wasn't going to feel none of that pain. It wasn't because he was Jesus that he wouldn't feel the nails in his hand. He wouldn't feel the thorn in his hand. Could you imagine thick thorns planted in your skull and blood dripping down your face and spears going through you, puncturing your side and laying on a cross and nails through your feet and just laying there on a cross, stood up only by nails in the sun. And that's not counting all the lashes that he had to go through and being thawed and flesh coming out of his back being beaten. Hallelujah. He knew he would have to go through all of that. So he said, Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me. But yet not my will, but your will be done. And then in that 43rd verse, as he was praying and crying out to God, verse 43 says, and an angel from heaven appeared to him and strengthened him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Beloved, let me tell you, God has no respect of person. And no matter what you're going through, no matter what your situation or what your circumstance is, that same angel that God sent for his son Jesus, he will send that same angel to you to strengthen you for whatever you're going through, whatever you're dealing with. He will send an angel to strengthen you the same way he did in Jesus. For he said in his word that we are co-heirs, hallelujah, with Jesus. So the same angel that he sent to Jesus, he'll send that same angel for you. And beloved, as I come to a close, see, Jesus was on the cross. And you would think the way it looked like, you would have thought that the story was over. That the enemy won. That everything that Jesus had come here for, that it was over. For even Peter had denied him three times that he even knew him because of what it looked like. Hallelujah. But beloved, let me tell you that as God is doing a great work in your life, let me tell you that a resurrection day, hallelujah, is coming in your life. That resurrection is coming. Don't worry about what it looked like. You may be on your cross right now. You may be going through all kind of hell in your life. But let me tell you, you tell God, Father, not my will, hallelujah, but your will be done. So God, what you're telling God is that no matter how you go, would take me through, no matter what I gotta go through, as long as I'm in your hands, as long as I'm in your will, I know resurrection is coming. I know that a day is coming in my life where you will lift me up on high and allow me to receive the glory that you planted in me. And I will walk the way you want me to walk. I will talk the way you want me to talk. Why? Because I believed in you and I said, not my will, hallelujah, but your will be done. Yes. Beloved, let me tell you, God is doing a great work in your life. No matter the situation, no matter the circumstance, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, God is doing a great work in your life. Baby, you go ahead and play that song. As we come to a close, I pray that you hear the words of this song. Great work in you. No matter what you go through, no matter your situation, you tell yourself, you remind yourself that God is doing a great work in me. In you. If you need to know this man named Jesus, We ask that you would come. Give your hand to me and your heart to Jesus so that God can begin a great work. Hallelujah. In you. And if there be one that you are saved and you've been caught up in what you see and what you feel and what you've been told and you need prayer on today so that you can be reminded of this great work that God is doing in you, we ask that you would come, that we may pray with you and touch and agree with God for you. And that if there be one, just keep playing, baby. If there be one that you say, Pastor, I hear you, I understand you, and I want to be in fellowship with this ministry. I want to be a part of this ministry that I can be a help to go out and touch these lost souls, and that I may be a part of a ministry where I can grow. We ask that you would come. We ask that you would come, that you may fellowship with us, grow with us, and be what God God, for the seeds that have been planted in each one of us. Lord, we ask that you would help, that we would not abort the seed of greatness that has been planted in us, Father. For we know that the enemy is standing by, trying to get us to abort the seed of greatness that you've planted in each and every one of us. But right now, in the name of Jesus, I bind the enemy. Hallelujah. I bind the enemy, and I bind all of his schemes. I bind all of his works, and I cast them out to the depths of the Red Sea. I give your name glory, God, that every great work shall be performed until you come in Jesus' name. I decree and declare that every man and every woman, that every boy and every girl, that every seed will manifest itself in greatness in your life. For God, we love you, we thank you, and we honor you for all that you are and all that you do. Cover us, Father, in the blood of Jesus, and keep us henceforth, now and forevermore. And everybody said, amen, amen, amen. Well, beloved, I pray that something was said today that would really has touched your life. And beloved, remember that no matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, no matter what that committee named they says to you, know that God is doing a great work in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to shake everybody's hand as we come to a close. Father, we thank you for another day. We honor you, God, for all you are and all that you do. Cover us, Father, in the blood of Jesus. Keep us henceforth, now and forevermore. Cover our families, our homes, and give us traveling mercies. For it is in the name of Jesus Christ that we pray. And we all said, amen. God bless you. God bless you. Shake everybody's hand. Amen.